So I got this like problem with my schedule and I kind of need it changed.
Well, sure, make yourself at home. Can I get you like a sparkling water or something?
No thanks, I have my double soy latte frappuccino.
Okay, well, what seems to be the problem with your class?
So they put me in this computer class, this gaming class that I'm not that interested in.
Well, that's really kind of a neat class. What don't you like about it?
Well, I'm not into that computer gaming stuff, but I mean, except for taking selfies.
Well, okay, let's see now. So what kind of classes did you pick on your course selection sheet last year? Let's see what kind of electives you picked.
What?
You did that last year, right?
Oh, that thing. Mm-hmm. I didn't think that was important.
Okay, well, let me see what I can do to fix your schedule.
Okay.
Okay. All right, well, here you go. Try that one on.
Cool, thanks.
Yeah, you bet. See you around.
What? Weightlifting?
Boom! Yeah, weightlifting. That's what you guys get when you don't pay attention to your advisory period. Make sure you guys listen up. We have an amazing episode for you guys today, all about how to register and get the perfect schedule for next year. All right, guys, in the spirit of getting you up off your parents' couch and never having to go back, today we're going to talk about how to get you out of high school and into college by getting you guys all the correct classes that you're going to need in order to graduate. So we're going to take a look at some of the classes that you had before, some of the classes that you have this year, and then we're going to organize everything for next year. The first thing that we're going to do is look at your core classes. And then after that, you guys are going to be free to pick out the electives that you hope to get next year. So make sure you pay attention to all of these instructions or else you might end up in weightlifting like homegirl. So the first step I want you to do is take out the three papers that we gave you guys. One is a graduation requirement checklist. The next one is an academic history. And the third one is a registration sheet. Put everything else away except for something to write with. You can go ahead, we'll wait. All right, so we're going to use the graduation checklist. That's going to give us a good idea of what you had, so that way we know exactly what you need to take next year. And it's really important for you guys to know, because one of the best college readiness skills is for you guys to take control of your own education and not rely on us to know exactly what you need. So now look at the academic history in front of you. It's the thing that looks like this. It probably has a whole bunch of classes on it. Sorry, freshmen, you'll get there one day. The first thing you want to do is look at your English classes here. For your English classes, go back to your graduation checklist sheet and check off any classes that you've already had. Then you can go on to the next section, which is math, and then on to science and social studies. Then at the bottom, you'll see a space for all of the miscellaneous electives that you need in order to graduate. All right, so what you want to do is you want to take that and the registration sheet around to all of your core academic teachers. That's, again, English, math, science, and social studies. So that way your teachers can evaluate your performance this year and make an awesome recommendation for you next year. Now that all of that stuff's out of the way, we get to do the fun part, which is pick out electives for next year. Use the registration sheet in front of you to pick out elective classes. Now, we know this is really exciting, but don't get carried away. You can only have a total of 8 credits per school year. So pick a few. Then in the bottom right-hand side, we need you to pick some backups. Backups are kind of like when you know who you want to go to the prom with, then you find out they're not available. So then you go with the backup. Pick out maybe 3 or 4 classes that you really wouldn't mind having if all else fails. If you're not sure what some of the elective classes are, on our school website, you'll find what's called a program of studies. A program of studies is simply a list of every single class that we offer here at North Fort Myers High School and a description. So make sure you check that out if you're not sure. All right, guys, we're gonna give you a few days to get all of this done and make sure they get handed in time, or down in the counseling department, we're just gonna have a lot of fun with your schedule. Get your registration sheet back to your English teachers, and that goes for all of you, freshman, sophomore, and junior. And seniors, if you're messing up, feel free to fill one out too. We wouldn't mind having you back next year.
I take every single piece of the blame if you want me to. But you know that there is no innocent one in this game for two. I go, and then you go, I didn't spill the truth. Can we both say the words and forget this? Yeah. Is it too late now to say sorry? 'Cause I'm missing more than just your body.